Today, we're taking a deep dive into the fascinating world of cells, the building blocks of all living things. We'll explore the key organelles inside plant and animal cells and highlight what makes them alike and different. Let's get started. Both plant and animal cells are eukaryotic, meaning they have a nucleus and various membrane-bound organelles. Think of these organelles as specialized departments within a tiny factory, each performing crucial tasks to keep the cell running smoothly. First, we have the nucleus, the command center of the cell. It houses the cell's DNA, the blueprint for all cellular activities, making it essential for both plant and animal cells. Next, we have the mitochondria, often called the powerhouses of the cell. These organelles generate energy by converting nutrients into ATP, the energy currency of the cell. Both plant and animal cells rely on mitochondria to fuel their activities. Let's move on to the endoplasmic reticulum, or ER for short. The ER comes in two forms, rough and smooth. The rough ER is studded with ribosomes, giving it a bumpy appearance, and is primarily involved in protein synthesis. The smooth ER, on the other hand, lacks ribosomes and is key in lipid synthesis and detoxification processes. Both types of ER are present in plant and animal cells. Speaking of ribosomes, these tiny structures are the protein factories of the cell. They can be found floating freely in the cytoplasm or attached to the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosomes are vital for building proteins in both plant and animal cells. Once proteins are made, they need to be processed and shipped to their final destinations, and that's where the Golgi apparatus comes in. This organelle modifies, sorts, and packages proteins and lipids, preparing them for transport within or outside the cell. Both plant and animal cells have a Golgi apparatus. Lysosomes and vesicles play crucial roles in cellular cleanup and transport. Lysosomes contain enzymes that break down waste and cellular debris, making them the cell's recycling centers. Vesicles, on the other hand, are like delivery trucks, transporting materials within the cell. Lysosomes are more common in animal cells, while vesicles are found in both plant and animal cells. Now, let's talk about the cell membrane, the protective barrier that surrounds both plant and animal cells. It's flexible and controls what enters and exits the cell, maintaining the cell's internal environment. Here's where plant cells start to differ. In addition to the cell membrane, plant cells have a rigid cell wall made of cellulose, which provides extra support and structure. Plus, they have chloroplasts, the green organelles responsible for photosynthesis, allowing plants to convert sunlight into food. These are features unique to plant cells. Vacuoles are present in both plant and animal cells, but differ in size and function. Plant cells typically have a large central vacuole that stores water, nutrients, and waste, helping to maintain cell structure. In contrast, animal cells have smaller, more numerous vacuoles for storage and waste disposal. So, while plant and animal cells share many organelles, they also have their unique features. Plant cells are equipped with a cell wall, chloroplasts, and a large central vacuole, while animal cells have lysosomes and smaller vacuoles. These differences reflect the distinct roles each type of cell plays in nature. Now that you've learned about the key organelles in plant and animal cells, why not explore further by examining cells under a microscope or creating a model? Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay tuned for more science content. Thanks for watching.